First, Minsk, Arias, Sis, Ilmos, Gus, Ora.
Quiet, bodyguard. Save your hissing for your own kind. As for you, slave, Darth Scotia is passing. Best get out of his way.
Darth Scotia can wait.
You're making a huge mistake, filth. Give your master a message for me. My eye is on her, and I know. Tell her that. I know what she's trying to do here on Dromund Kaas. You and your master have gotten this far, but it ends here, slave. I alone have the key. Tell her that. You and your master have no future on Dromund Kaas or in the Sith Order. Tell her that. Now, get out of my way.
What do you think? Can you eat him?
Jani Bragais, uns in Freistubnajal.
Fools!
My lord, Lieutenant Malohi, may I beg a moment of your time?
Are you really going to beg? I might enjoy that.
If my lord requires. I humbly ask my lord for the honor of speaking so that we might both serve the needs of the Empire.
Rise and report, Lieutenant.
At this moment, Lord Kraas is meeting with the Minister of War to make recommendations for our next moves against the Republic. I have prepared his reports, but he also desires a personal interview with someone involved in the recent fighting.
Tell me where to find your lord, and I'll be on my way.
He's in the Citadel. Please proceed in a timely fashion. It is only with the insight and wisdom of the Sith that we can hope to win this war and conquer the hated Republic forever.
I'm Commander Ryland, my lord. I apologize for my abruptness, but I'm afraid I must request assistance with an emergency. Something is stirring up the jungle beasts, which makes the route between here and Kaas City hazardous. Several individuals traveling on foot have disappeared. I've even had reports of jungle beasts attacking speeders.
Dromund Kaas is going to be more exciting than I thought.
Ah, yes, my lord. As you say, however, this situation cannot be allowed to continue. I dispatched two commando teams into the jungle to clear out the beasts, but they never returned. An emergency holo message came through from one of the team leaders. I'll play it for you.
Repeat. Landing beacons are emitting some kind of energy. Power surges are driving the beasts mad. Can't get close enough to reroute power. Lost my team. Beasts closing in. Need reinforced. Ah!
Sensors confirm unusual energy readings in the jungle. The spaceport's landing beacons appear to be the cause.
Just show me where the fun is.
I'm deeply grateful for your assistance, my lord. The spaceport's landing beacons are scattered throughout the nearby jungle. You'll need to reroute power on all of them. I'll track your progress from here. Return when you're done. Good luck. The jungle predators are fierce. Welcome back, my lord. Sensors indicate you rerouted power to all the landing beacons. Analysis indicates they were deliberately sabotaged to drive the jungle beasts insane. I am transmitting a full report to Kaas City. Please accept this and my deepest gratitude, my lord. I bid you good day.
Finally, someone who can keep their head in a crisis. Rebel slaves hit my team in the jungle. They stole weapons, supplies. As if that wasn't bad enough, the idiots ransacked our spires for parts. Without those components, we've got a lightning spire building up dangerous energy levels. It'll crater half of Kaas City if it blows.
How long until the spire explodes?
I can't say for sure. We should have at least enough time to avert the disaster. Most of my men ran off. Some tried to reclaim the spire parts, but the rebels cut them down. I came back here for reinforcements. We need to recover the components the rebels stole and get that lightning spire back online before it goes critical.
The rebel scum will wish they'd never touched the spires.
Excellent. I'll hold off raising the alarm for a while longer. The rebels are camped along the river. Blast them down, pry the stolen components from their hands, and then reinstall them at the spire. If the river runs red with rebel blood, I'll throw in something extra.
You can relax. I replaced the spire components.
I was just about to call in evacuation orders for the city. Well done. The rebel slaves will think twice before tampering with Imperial property again.
My lord, I have reports from the conflict with the Republic.
You have my thanks. You are, if I'm not mistaken, the young Sith who took the Brentall Star, yes? Tell me, what were your impressions of the Republic forces you fought?
One Imperial soldier is worth 20-30 of the Republic's grunts.
Then this should be a very short war. I thank you for your insight in these reports. If you'll excuse me, I must study them before giving the Minister of War his marching orders.
Are you acquainted with a big, ugly, half-machine Dark Lord? He had a message for you.
Damn Scotia! What business has he, going behind my back, speaking to my apprentice? Trying to intimidate you, no doubt. Wretched monster. More machine than man and dangerously powerful. Ever since I arrived on Dromund Kaas as an apprentice, he's made every effort to stand in my way.
Ustaitnians and Parana, Rahitis ni Aino.
Ultimately, we cannot even begin the search for Tulakhord's ancient power with Scotia's rattling breath on our necks.
Somebody should stop him from breathing, then.
Yes, and that somebody is you. You are going to kill Scotia for me.
Finally, a challenge worthy of me.
Good. That is precisely the attitude you'll need.
I cannot be tied to Scotia's murder. Brazen power plays make the Dark Council nervous. But nobody will believe that a mere apprentice could defeat Scotia. It's impossible, and that's why it will work.
The impossible's my speciality.
So it seems.
I've begun to piece together the puzzle for Darth Scotia's destruction, but some elements have yet to fall into place. Out in the jungle, a group of slaves has recently revolted. They were working on a colossal statue that has since gone unfinished. I believe Scotia is hiding something of great importance near this statue. Get the archaeological plans to the area from one of the slaves, and contact me by holocommunicator.
In biso ze waitai spira pres in kretai. In bise e wanata ataragata indais.
Exactly as reported. A degree 6 revolt, population equivalent to the Duros uprising on Xilior. Subjects occupy a moderate radius of jungle. Good. Good. Welcome, apprentice. Your timing couldn't be better. I am Lord Drowl. When the Empire encounters resistance on its conquered worlds, they call me. I'm here to end the slave uprising on Dromund Kaas.
You enjoy your job, don't you?
Dominating lesser beings and squashing their will to resist? Of course I enjoy it. I think you will too. The situation is this. A Sith Lord was constructing a colossal statue of himself in the jungle. His slaves revolted and armed themselves. The Colossus remains unfinished and well-armed slaves now control the jungle. An embarrassment for the Empire, but an opportunity for me.
Sounds like the perfect opportunity to thin the slave population.
Slave deaths will be a byproduct of my plan, but not the focus. I'm testing a toxic weapon, a poison called Quell. Its victims experience a prolonged state of agonizing pain before finally dying. The victim's allies are so horrified by Quell's effects, they lose their wills to resist. At least that's what I intend to prove.
Sounds like a worthy cause.
Yes. Cowing the masses is a complex art. It requires a great deal of fine-tuning. I need someone to introduce a controlled amount of Quell into the slave's water supply so that I can determine the proper dosage. The work is dangerous. There will be armed slaves everywhere. But your success will be well rewarded. What do you say?
I'll always aid in the advancement of the killing sciences.
I suspected as much. My assistant, Sergeant Slerin, will recommend the correct dosage of Quell and give you a supply. See him at the research tent.
If I know Lord Drowl's tastes, which unfortunately I do, he sent you for the Quell toxin.
The sooner we get this done, the better.
Impatient? Of course you are. My superior certainly knows how to choose his assistants. What if I told you this experiment is pointless? That past studies have shown increased suffering has no impact on the speed of surrender. This has nothing to do with accelerating the end of a rebellion. Lord Drowl simply takes perverse thrill in gratuitous suffering.
Yawn.
Don't you see?
Lord Drow compromises efficiency for his own twisted fixations. I want this assignment over with. The faster this rebellion ends, the faster I'll be reassigned to more important work. Serving Lord Drow's bloodlust has stunted my career. If not for his inefficiency, I'd be a captain by now.
You're awfully enamored of yourself.
I know my potential, just as I know who's holding me back from achieving it. Lord Drow's dosage of Quell Toxin will have slaves writhing in agony for pointless weeks, during which this area will remain volatile. I've prepared a dose that will kill the slaves efficiently, which is better for the Empire and for me. Will you deliver my dosage instead?
I want these renegade slaves to pay for disobeying the Empire.
You're not merely prolonging the slaves' agony, but my own as well. Committed to your work, aren't you? Very well. Take the Quell Toxin and inject it into the slave camp's water filtration systems. See Lord Drow for your payment when you're done.
My lord? Look at them out there. They're like animals. Hundreds of slaves with no one to command them and without a thought in their minds as to what to do with their freedom. Like I said, the slaves are animals. But we've noticed strange behavior in the pack. And my superiors want to know more. Some of the slaves are killing each other. We don't know if they're mad or hungry, desperate, or if there's a faction of slaves who've turned on the rest.
I can see how a slave civil war would prove useful.
Exactly what the higher-ups are saying. That the killers could potentially be manipulated. We know that the killings are ritualistic. The murderous slaves come in the night, stab their foes, and paint themselves in blood. If you could investigate, catch them in the act and take them down, maybe you could find a clue to their motives.
I'll see what I can do. But I remember what it was like, being one of them.
Ah, yes. Yes, my lord, of course. Look for any slave who's turned on his peers. With luck, he'll lead us to answers.
You. You're not the initiate. You are Sith. You honor us with your presence, mighty lord. Welcome to our prison.
Start talking. But move wrong, and I kill you.
You want explanations? I am Traka Unvor. Leader of the Unchained. I am master of my hatred. When the other slaves broke free, I laughed. Like you, I knew their escape was a delusion, for only Sith possess true freedom.
I hope you plan to elaborate.
I know the Sith code. Freedom comes through power, through victory. I saw a chance to prove myself. I culled weak from strong. I began to kill and to teach. I showed slaves freedom through bloodshed. Now my followers and I are the masters here. And soon, we will become Sith ourselves.
By all means, continue.
We are hateful. We are powerful. We are free. In this way, we are already Sith. Now you can spread word of us to the Empire. Your strength is great. With your approval, we shall serve. Carry our message of allegiance to your masters, and we will become the new face of the Empire. We will be champions of the dark side.
The Empire will hear your message.
As it should be. Take this datapad, my plea to the Sith Lords. For now, I am not ready to leave the Colossus. With every kill, I feel my power grow. And there are many slaves who may yet join me. But soon, we will all be ready. We will await word from the Empire.
You may do as you wish, but you don't yet understand the Sith.
Yes. I look forward to learning.
It's good to see you back. I knew those slaves couldn't hold their own against you. I take it you managed to track down one of the murderers. What's their story? Can we use them?
The killers will now serve the Empire. I have their oath of allegiance here.
What do you mean? Let me see that datapad. This is madness. They're serious. Slaves who think they can become Sith.
A slave can become Sith. Never forget that.
Yes, as you say. I'll inform Command. I'm not actually authorized to speak with Sith Lords on the blockade. But I'll make sure they know, too. It's been an honor working with you. I hope we meet again.
Does this mean you found them? You found the archaeological plans?
Of course, my master.
Fantastic. I never doubted you. Now, let me see. Ah, yes. How clever. There's a chamber hidden under the Colossus itself. I bet my complete collection of Nagasado's Yavin 4 writings that you'll find what we're looking for in this chamber.
Tell me how to access this chamber.
There should be a hidden entrance near the Colossus. It looks like Scotia has an entire underground base. You're looking for a tablet. The tablet is the symbol of leadership of an obscure Trandoshan cult. The lizards believe it was a gift from their deity, the Scorekeeper. Scotia stole the tablet and uses it to exert control over his Trandoshan bodyguards. Give them their relic, and Scotia's power over his bodyguards will turn to vapor.
We'll leave Scotia undefended.
Exactly. You have a sharp mind, apprentice. The plans suggest Scotia's apprentices guard this base. I don't doubt they hold the keys to acquiring the Trandoshan tablet. Best kill them all, to be sure.
Inupis just nas jans, now mipan astana tods jans.
You delivered the exact results I hoped for. Quell is like an imbibed torture device infesting those rebel slaves. It's exhilarating to see the effects on the survivors who can only stand by and watch helplessly.
I'm happy to see you're so pleased.
Quell toxin will be a great asset to the Empire. Uprisings will end painfully and decisively. You've earned your reward, my friend. Now go. I have horror and despair to observe and chronicle.
I've recovered the Trandoshan relic.
Then we've both had success in our endeavors. But the Trandoshan bodyguards are only part of Scotia's defense. His greatest weakness is that he's mostly machine. The rogue Sith Lord, Grathan, is holding a cyborg expert named Dorotsek captive. He has developed a neutralizer for me, the kind that should destroy Scotia's cyborg elements. Find Dorotsek, get him to tell you where the neutralizer is, and then silence him.
Of course, my master.
Grathan's estate is in the jungle. Interrogate the scientist. With any luck, Scotia will soon be out of our way, and then we'll be free to pursue Tulak Horde's lost power as we please.
Ustaitnians anparana, rahitis ni aino.
Please, tell me Lord Zashthentu. Please, I can't stand it here any longer. I don't want to die.
Are you Grathan's cyborg expert in chains?
Yes. Yes, I am. And I got just what you need. Just what Lord Zash ordered. My finest work yet, though I don't quite see what the use of it is.
If you hope to trick me into revealing something, your hopes are poorly placed indeed.
No, I don't want to know any more than is good for me. I'm just warning you. Lord Zash commissioned this weapon against cyborgs. The thing is, most cyborgs are only 10% machine. You'd need someone at least 50% machine for the neutralizer to do any real damage.
Oh, my mark's 50% machine, at least.
I don't want to know. I don't want to know. If you want it, take it. It's only a prototype, but I guess it'll work if there's one droid you really want to bash. It's in the lab building, can't be missed. But Grantham wouldn't let me have the power cells I need to power it. You'll need to steal those off his droids.
Looks like it's your turn to die now.
No, please. Lord Zash said she'd free me.
It is rare for a slave to rise so far, so fast. That takes a very clever sword. I am the apprentice and voice of Darth Charnas. I speak in his name, and I would bargain for your services.
You have my complete, undivided attention.
I require individuals capable of gaining prestige in a society weaned on secrecy and madness. Individuals who can earn respect, if not love. I need infiltrators to eliminate an enemy of the Sith. You would serve well.
I serve no one. I suggest you learn that quickly.
I chose my words poorly. I apologize, but you are needed. Our enemy is the Order of Revan, a cult of fools hidden at every stratum of Imperial society. For years, the Revanite heretics have secretly recruited military officers, powerful Sith, wealthy mercenaries, anyone who can add to their power.
You want me to join them, I take it?
I want you to help my master ruin them. Instead of following the Emperor and his Dark Council, the Revanites follow a long-dead Sith Lord, tainted by Jedi ways. If you can uncover the Revanite leader's identity for us, my master will reveal him to the Dark Council. His destruction would be assured. All you have to do is join the cult. I can get you inside, but you must earn their trust.
I'm sure they'll take to me immediately.
The Revanites have a secret compound in the jungle. Take this token to the cultist at the entrance. He will initiate you. Earn an audience with their leader. When you have seen his face, return here, and you shall have your reward.
Did you lose your way in the jungle? You have my sympathies, but we can't help. We have no food or water to offer. There's nothing for you here, and strangers are not welcome in this place. You'd best be going.
I was given this token. Does it tell you anything?
I'm not sure. Ah, you do have the token. Someone must have had great faith in you to send you our way. Welcome to the Order of Revan, Initiate. Welcome to your new life.
What is this place?
This place is our haven, built by the Master and protected by the faithful. Here we leave our duties to the Empire behind. This is where the Master guides us in the mysteries of Revan, the one who began a Jedi but grew into a Sith, and then something more.
There's nothing greater than the Sith. Nothing more to achieve.
Is that right? The Sith are a path to power. But is the Sith philosophy where that path ends? As a Jedi, Revan was a warrior who slaughtered armies. As a Sith, Revan was a teacher who trained 1,000 dark apprentices. Eventually, Jedi and Sith both turned on Revan. But instead of being destroyed, Revan was reborn.
What do you mean, reborn? What was Revan's final fate?
Revan was stripped of power, stripped of life, of memory, and left to rot. And still, Revan relearned the ways of the Force. The reborn Revan destroyed Jedi and Sith, and came to Dromund Kaas. Although Revan's life ended here, the Master preserved that life, so that we may learn from it.
Your knowledge might prove useful.
Revan mastered the light side and the dark side, war and peace. We seek to walk the same path. Take part in our rituals, learn Revan's path to greatness, succeed, and you earn the right to join us.
Then I look forward to learning.
Around you, you'll find your new teachers, Revanites who have spent their lives recovering the works of Darth Revan. Speak to them. Complete the tasks you are given. When you are through, return to me, and the Master will give you your final lessons.
Come here. Come closer. You are among the initiates who wish to join our order, and this is good. But tell me something. You are here because of the Order of Revan. Are you ready to die for us?
I don't quite understand.
Consider carefully, for every Revanite must face the trial of death, just as Revan died at the hands of the Jedi and Sith. Death freed Revan, left him unbound from all oaths and promises. It paved his road to rebirth. Will death free you from your past?
I left my past behind when I became Sith.
Then you have nothing to fear. Before us is a path. Beyond the path is a cave. A cave dedicated to Darth Revan. Initiates fall on the path. Initiates are torn apart by things inside the cave. But initiates who reach the end are reborn. Remade.
You expect me to go to this cave?
I expect nothing of you. The choice to walk the path of Revan or to return to the life you left is yours. The path is here. The cave. The cave will be more trying.
The more challenging, the better.
Remember, survival is not your goal. Trust in the path of Darth Revan. We have nothing more to discuss. Go and return to me when you reach the end of the cave. You return, dripping with the blood of the womb you are reborn.
Your old life, everything you were, all of it is dead, buried inside that cave.
What was that place? It was strange.
Darth Revan's shrine. Every piece of Revan's life that we've recovered is in that cave. It's the last thing initiates see before dying. Tell me how it feels. Your obligations have vanished. Your past no longer burdens you. How does it feel to see the world reborn?
It feels different. Just different.
So it should. You've done well. And I'm proud that you've begun your new life as a Revanite. Choosing allegiance to us, first of all. Take this gift to guide you in your new life. It will remind you of what you've become. Leave now, and may the Force make you strong.
Come forward. Speak to me. We're all students of Darth Revan, and I enjoy the company of initiates.
I remember when I was like you. I remember my trials and the joy of killing in the Master's name. You're so fortunate.
I don't need a cult leader to tell me when or whom to kill.
Neither did I, but you'll find that killing as a Revanite is more fulfilling. I'm Ladra. Once the personal assassin of a Sith Lord, I am now the serene protector of the Master and his students.
I contemplate Revan's teachings as I execute intruders and heretics, but I also guide initiates and help determine their trials.
I must say, I'm very impressed.
Thank you. Your praise is kind, but unneeded. Helping you join us will be reward enough.
Every Revanite's initiation includes a trial of the past, a rite to bind the initiate to Revan. Your rite will be very special. You will find the mask of Darth Revan, what he wore after becoming Sith. It's a powerful symbol of his greatness, long lost to us.
Retrieving forgotten lore is my speciality.
Then I'm glad to put your skills to use.
The mask is in a collection of antiquities possessed by my former teacher, the Sith Lord Grathan. It must be freed from that heretic, rescued in a rain of blood and death.
Murder and mayhem await.
Speak to Torun, our curator. He'll give you the spiritual guidance you need and tell you where the mask is. When your journey's done, bring the mask to me. Good luck. Welcome the peace that comes with serving the Master.
What have we got here? I wasn't expecting a visit from any initiates, but you're welcome to stay and talk, in any case. I'm Torun, devoted servant of the Master and student of Revan. What can I do for you?
I'm searching for Darth Revan's mask. I'm told you can help.
So, Ladra sent you. She wants me to ritually prepare you for contact with Revan's mask, eh? A pointless ceremony. Ladra's devoted to the Revanites. She's also obsessed with that mask. Says it talks to her. Ladra wants the mask to represent everything Revan ever was, but he wasn't just Sith. Before his rebirth, he was both Sith and Jedi.
Now you've got me interested.
Good. I hoped as much. It's tempting to seek answers in material objects. Ladra will use the mask to teach that Revan was a being of only darkness. I don't want that mask becoming our Order's sole focus. Bring it to me. I'll keep it safe among a few like-minded scholars.
You don't exactly come away empty-handed.
I'm not after the mask for myself. I have no use for it, except for what it represents. I'm sure Ladra promised a grand reward for the mask. I can't match it, but I can promise your initiation will proceed smoothly. Will you help me preserve the real Revan? Or will you let Ladra overshadow everything with a Sith relic?
I'll bet that mask would look good on me.
I doubt it's in any condition to wear. Still, that would be better than giving it to Ladra. I don't have to tell you to be careful, but may the Force be with you. May it keep you strong and guide your return.
Ah, you've returned. You must have talked to Tarun by now. Did you make it out to the estate? Did you? Did you see the mask? Wasn't it amazing?
I have the mask right here.
Oh, you have it. I never thought I'd see it again. Free from Grathan's prison at last. Free from the hands of heretics. It's a wonderful day.
My trial is complete. The mask is yours now.
I wish I'd been there, cutting Grathan's apprentices to pieces again and again. But it was your trial, your privilege. I have a gift for you, to celebrate your success and the completion of the rite. I can't finish your initiation, only the master can do that. But I can recognize achievement. You've done so very well. The mask will guide us forevermore.
More initiates? The compound's getting less secure all the time. Still, I suppose the master knows what he's doing. And if you can follow the ways of Revan, we'll judge your worth.
What ways are you talking about?
Revan didn't work alone. Revan had allies, all walks of life. We're no different. You want to join us? You need to face the men and women who got here first and who've proved that they're loyal to the master.
What exactly does this entail?
You need to show those in the master's inner circle that you understand Revan's teachings. They'll ask questions. You'll answer. If they're not satisfied, they'll abandon the test of wisdom and begin your test of strength. Revan didn't suffer the weak.
I'd expect nothing less. I'll do what's needed.
I'm glad to hear that. Your pilgrimage starts in the jungle. You'll find your first guide there. He'll determine whether you're worth sending on to the rest. Be ready for anything, initiate. The jungle's dangerous, and so are the true Revanites.
So, you have come. You who would join the Order of Revan. I am Moron Dokas, Lord of Beasts. I am Revanite, and I am Sith. What do you say to me?
Moron Dokas, I've come to prove myself worthy.
Very well. Then listen. For decades I have served the Master. He found me when I was a larva and saw that I was strong in the Force. Against the Empire's traditions he trained me. This is the way of Revan, to teach all species the path to power.
Your meaning is clear.
Good. Now you will answer a question. And you will answer well, or face the claws of my pets. Why do you think Revan trained aliens in the ways of the Sith? Why did Revan offer power to all seekers?
Revan knew that servants are more useful when they're powerful.
You answer well. You answer wisely. You speak like a true Revanite. You may proceed on your pilgrimage and seek worth in the eyes of another.
Who should I be looking for?
A Revanite. A great warrior, and a favored student of the Master. Seek the mercenary called Setafar as she teaches her soldiers. Then shall your trial continue.
Tarkin, have some of the men head into the city. They've earned a break from training.
Yes, Commander.
It's good to see you alive. Not everyone makes it past Morin. Raymond contacted me from the base. Said you wanted to join our society. Is it true?
It's true. I'm seeking the approval of the Inner Circle.
I'm called Setafar. I teach these mercenaries how to fight. My service to the Master is a matter of honor. Centuries ago, my clan fought Revan when we invaded the Republic with the rest of the Mandalorians. It was our privilege to battle Jedi. We lost the war over Malkor V, but that was a privilege too. It's out of respect for Revan that I agreed to join the Master.
I see what you're saying.
I serve the Order to ensure Revan's name isn't forgotten. Revan was a warrior, a leader, and deserves to be remembered. Since you're not bound by honor, how do I know you won't sully the Dark Lord's memory? What can you do for the Order in Revan's name?
I can fight. I'll battle the Order's enemies wherever there's need.
Good. But I need proof of that. I sent out a squad of clansmen to hunt the local wildlife. They're camped nearby. Defeat them, or get yourself killed. And don't worry. Tarkin here will make sure they know you're coming.
Yes, Commander.
Revan earned the respect of my grandfathers and grandmothers by defeating them in battle. Now you've earned mine. You're not Revan. Not yet, at least. But you're something. You've got my approval to join the Order.
Are we finished?
I'm finished. You're not. You'll need to talk to one more person before you head back to the compound. Find Major Pathel. He oversees security on the wall.
I'll be there in but a moment.
Glory to Mandalore, and glory to our master.
Come on over. There's nothing to trouble us here, and we can speak freely. I'm Major Pathel, at your service. It's always wonderful to meet new initiates. The Order of Revan needs all the dedicated young people it can get.
You're awfully cheerful, aren't you?
A necessary precondition of living on the Wall, I think. To keep healthy out here, one needs spirit. I don't know how your other meetings went, but I like to conduct these interviews informally. No point making your life difficult, eh? Quite a few initiates, young officers, acolytes and the like, think our secret society will help them become morphs or dark lords. You're not like that, I presume?
The Order of Revan intrigues me, but I don't need it to get what I want.
You're ambitious, that's a fine trait. Don't let it get the better of you, though. Not every initiate realizes that advancement in the Revanites does not guarantee advancement in the Empire, nor how dangerous being a Revanite really is. The Dark Council seeks to root us out. So, how do we respond? How do we answer the Empire's accusations of heresy?
We need to show our enemies the truth.
And we will, wherever we can. Not to say we shouldn't defend ourselves, but we won't become traitors to the Empire either. That's all I needed to make my judgment. I'm going to send a message to the compound. Raymond will be waiting for you.
If everything's settled, I'll be leaving.
Journey safely, and be proud to be a part of the Order of Revan.
So you finished the pilgrimage. Not bad. I don't know what happened out there. It's none of my business. But the Inner Circle approves of your initiation.
How often do initiates fail?
Honestly? If you can survive the pilgrimage, you're probably a worthy initiate. But a lot of initiates don't survive at all. You did good in this trial. Now you'll have to find someone else to show you the next stage of the journey.
I appreciate the help.
Good luck. Every step brings you closer to the Master.
Well, you really made it, didn't you? I've been hearing a lot about your progress, hearing about your trials. Your initiation has not been an easy one. But you've met the challenge and showed you can walk Revan's path. Now you may undergo the final rite.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
The Master will complete your lessons, and you'll be welcomed as a full member of the Order of Revan. This is a great privilege. The Master reveals himself to no one outside the Order.
Where do I find him?
You may go to the Master in his chamber. He'll be waiting for you. Listen to him, obey him. Through the Master, you will know the path of Revan.
You who have died and been reborn, stand before me now. You who have reclaimed the ancient past, stand before me now. You who have demonstrated power and wisdom to my followers, look upon the Master of the Order of Revan.
As you say.
This is the end of your initiation and the beginning of your true journey. You will walk the path of Revan forevermore. The enemies of the Order will force you to move in shadows. But we shall keep your secrets safe, as you shall keep ours.
The time for subterfuge is over. Know me for who I am. I thought the Master was a man.
The ruse serves its purpose. Besides, it felt appropriate. Revan's own gender is unclear in many of our records. I apologize for the deception, and for not meeting you sooner. But you must know how badly the Dark Council wants me dead. The Order of Revan threatens everything the Dark Council prizes.
What makes the Order such a threat?
Revan came to Dromund Kaas after being reborn. Some believe Revan died at the hands of our Emperor. I believe otherwise. I believe Revan overthrew the Emperor and has sat secretly on the throne for 3 centuries. Aside from our Order, only the Dark Council knows the truth.
I don't like where this is leading.
I have heard whispers in the Citadel. For decades, the Emperor has been in seclusion. The Dark Council no longer speaks with him. The only explanation is this. The Dark Council betrayed their leader and locked Emperor Revan away, seizing power for themselves. They seek to silence us because we know.
I think I've heard enough conspiracy theories.
It's difficult, I know, to think that our great Emperor suffers. But I would ask you for your help. My agents tell me that you met with a Sith named Sandor. A man who seeks to destroy the Revanites. End his threat. Go to Sandor and tell him that you met the Revanite leader. Tell him that the leader is his own master, Darth Charnas.
What makes you think I won't betray you instead?
You're one of us now. I put my trust in you, Revanite. I obtained this Sith amulet from Charnas. Give it to Sandor, He'll believe you stole it from his master while among the Revenites. They will turn against each other. When this is done, though, when you have spoken to Sandor, you cannot return here.
Somehow, I'm not terribly disappointed.
Sandor must never suspect your true allegiance. You must walk the path of Revan on your own. The path to power. The path neither Jedi nor Sith. May the Force be with you. May it make you strong.
The clever slave turned master. You return from having your ears filled with lies by the Revanites. I do not envy you the experience. Tell me now, did you find what we need? Did you see the face of the leader?
She's a Sith Lord. Dark-skinned with black hair and tattoos.
I know her.
I know her, yes! Tari Darkspanner.
My master knows her. We will use her. The Dark Council will strip her of her power, her mind, and her life.
Whatever you can do to her and her people, it isn't enough.
Likely true, but I'm sure the punishment will suffice. I promised you a reward in the name of Darth Jarnas, so you shall have it. You have served the Empire well. Thanks to you, we have the means to obliterate this society of heretics. The name of Revan will be spoken on Dromund Kaas no more.
All history is eventually devoured by darkness.
You speak truly. Leave me now. It is time to put Darth Charnas' plans into action.
Not a moment too soon, apprentice. Tell me we were successful. Tell me you have the tech we need to destroy Scotia.
I have the prototype.
Fantastic. Magnificent. Perfect. Then the time to do the deed is now. Scotia is in his chambers as we speak. Be ready. Even with the power you have over him, he will be a frightful sight.
Gahosida patwait wadayap.
Set your nerves of cortosis. Turn your fear into hatred. Remember, Scotia stands between us and glory.
Let's get to the killing.
Good. Now listen closely. This is how you will kill Scotia. The relic you found under the Colossus is the key to Scotia's power over his Trandoshan bodyguards. Go to Scotia's chambers and show them the relic. The Trandoshans should stand down, or attack him or something. The confusion should be enough. This is the first step.
Then I use the anti-cyborg prototype to disable him, right?
Exactly. With the bodyguards gone, you can get close enough to Scotia to use the prototype you stole from Grathans. But be mindful. Scotia may be more machine than man, but he's no weakling in the Force. Killing him will still be a challenge.
It wouldn't be fun if it wasn't.
Oh, I wish I could be there to see the contortions on Scotia's malformed face when you destroy him. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm due to make an appearance at a party in the Nexus Room Cantina. Meet me there when you're done.
I see. Nothing yet. What makes this slave so bold as to enter my chambers? Tell me, slave, are you insane, or do you have a death wish?
I've been asked to kill you, and I hate to disappoint.
Skeesk.
Kill her.
No, I'm not. The dark hat grows up.
I'm your master now.
And Scotia, I'm going to ask. Dark Grievo, Texas Yazin, Natchkit, Vooja,
Bursa Rukwa, Chartesa.
Clever. Zash must have stayed up many a night to think of that one. I suppose you'll be sending my bodyguards away now, or maybe you'll order them to kill me.
You're free to leave any time.
Just or not.
You shouldn't have done that. The bodyguards, they're nothing. Show. But you subverted my authority.
took my slaves from me, and that makes me angry. And killing you will be over too soon. No, I think you're going to have to suffer first.
Papagawan.
What is this? How did you... Zash! Zash! You've killed me!
How does it feel to be killed by a slave, Scotia?
Mindless. You don't know what Zash can do. Think of how many years she must have spent plotting my death. She will kill you, just like she's killed me.
If that day comes, I'll be ready for her.
Well, when I'd heard she'd taken up with a Mandalorian, I was scandalized. Just scandalized.
A Mandalorian? Does nobody value Sith blood these days?
I know, I know. Don't you think so, Zash?
I places Amin's Waihai's fools. Gawandida seek from Tauhans.
I'm sorry. Will you excuse me? I need to have a quick chat with my apprentice.
If you must. Now, as I was saying.
Thank the Emperor you've arrived. It doesn't matter how much one drinks. These parties are just dull, 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 dull. I hope you've come to cheer me up.
I have dismantled the machine.
He's dead, then? Excellent. You have performed magnificently, apprentice. None of this would have been possible without you.
Lord Zash.
Darthanaton, I'm honored.
Don't let me interrupt you.
Don't go anywhere just yet, apprentice. This call won't take long, and I have some further instructions for you. As I said, my lord, I'm honored. But why call me?
You have nerve, Zash. Nerve. But I thought you were smarter.
With all respect, Darthanaton, I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't play ignorant with me, Zash. Scotia's dead, and you killed him.
Scotia? Dead? That's the first I've heard of it. When did this happen?
Just now, Zash, and you know it. What did you expect to gain? His position? His title? You know it doesn't work that way. Where's your discretion?
Discretion? I've been at this party for ages. I may have had a little much to drink, but I'm fairly certain I haven't murdered anyone. Though I have always fancied Scotia's chambers. So much more shelf space.
Zash, I don't want to have this conversation by Hollow. Report to my chambers immediately.
Yes, Darthanaton. It'll be my pleasure.
Are we in trouble?
Give me time to talk to Thanaton and then meet me in Darth Scotia's chambers. And don't worry. You've played your part, now it's time for me to play mine. We did it, apprentice.
There. There she is. It's Lord Zash's apprentice. Surely she knows.
You wouldn't tell us if she did.
Warpine's brigand Iswis Buidan.
Still, it doesn't hurt to ask, does it?
Colonel, let it rest.
I will not let it rest. Everyone knows Lord Zash was at the party when Scotia was killed, and yet everyone knows she killed him. She somehow devised a way of being in two places at once. If I let it rest, we'll all be dead.
Don't be silly. I'm the one who killed Scotia.
Now you're the one who's being silly.
I wouldn't underestimate her, Colonel. She looks dangerous enough to me.
But a Dark Lord of the Sith? She's only an apprentice, Calaveras. Please, you must tell me. How did Zash kill Darth Scotia?
Well, first she got a droid, and then a wig.
Clearly she's not going to tell you, Kiernan. Let it rest.
Fine then, fine. But I'm warning you, Calaveras. Lord Zash is becoming too powerful too quickly. Since when has anyone in the history of the Sith committed a murder so brazenly, yet made it appear that she was somewhere else the entire time? It's enough to wake the Emperor, I tell you.
Perfect timing, Apprentice. I just met with that insufferable Thanaton, and I have good news.
Everyone's talking about how you killed Scotia.
Good. Let them talk. They can't prove anything, and it'll drive them mad. And my meeting went exactly as I planned. You would have been proud of me. I went in to a reprimand, but I emerged a Darth.
Do I get a promotion too?
For now, you remain my capable apprentice. However, a Darth can raise an apprentice to a lord, so your prospects just improved. Remember the map you found on Korriban that pointed us to the power of Tulak Horde? The first piece of that artifact, that power, is here on Dromund Kaas. This piece is in the deepest chamber of the Dark Temple. Scotia always hoarded the key to the chamber like a hut hoards his credits. Now I have Scotia's title, his chambers, his research, and his key. He always said I would enter the Dark Temple over his rusting corpse. However, I won't be the one to go into the Dark Temple. You will.
It will be my pleasure.
Before I went to Korriban to choose an apprentice, a furious apparition awakened in the Dark Temple, implacable in its anger, murdering all who trespassed on the innermost chamber. But I had a dream. An apprentice of low origin humbled himself, or herself as it happened, before the apparition, pacifying it. That's why you and your peers were chosen.
Wait, you want me to bow to this apparition?
You must go into the temple and face the apparition. And when you do, I believe that your humility will be the key. Still, I want you to know, I'm not certain you're the one from my dream. I fear I may be sending you to your death.
Don't worry about me, Master.
You're right. You retrieved the holocron from Korriban when no one else could. If that's not proof of your destiny, I don't know what is. Tulak Horde's power awaits us both. We must not lose sight of this goal. Use this glyph to enter the innermost chamber of the Dark Temple. Humble yourself before the apparition, and bring back the piece of the artifact.
Sai galut saida, iswis us ulfbundan, ja atnam, in puidangar ja.
Talking about?
Ah, you don't know me. Has our family fallen so far that the daughter of my daughters does not know the name of Kallik, the name so long revered in the annals of the Sith? You are my descendant. By how many generations, I do not know. But know this, your strength in the Force has awakened me from my stupor.
What do you mean, I awakened you?
When the weaklings of this planet trespassed my tomb, I rose, resuming my former life. This temple became my kingdom, and I was once more a lord of the Sith. But when you first grasped the hilt of your lightsaber, I knew my hour had come and gone, that your strength, not mine, would return our family to glory.
But I'm a former slave.
That is my shame. I was once one of the greatest lords of the Sith. If I'd been wiser, I could have secured my family's greatness. But I let down my guard and was betrayed by a man called Tulak Horde, whom I trusted as a friend.
I places Amin's Waihai's fools. Gawain did a seek from Tauhans.
Ha! Your master is dead, beast. You serve the child of Kalik now. Flesh of my flesh, you should teach your servant to obey.
I will deal with him as I see fit.
Fair enough. I only caution you not to take obedience for granted. In restoring our bloodline to glory, you must not make the same mistake. Treachery is the Sith's endless game. You must win it.
Don't worry about me.
Beware your master. Beware your apprentice. Never be taken by surprise. Do these things, and you will be unstoppable. But you have not come to see me. You have come for the artifact I managed to wrest from Tulak Horde before he died. Take the artifact, but be careful. I know not what it does, only that betrayal follows it everywhere.
When betrayal shows up, I'll kill it.
If only all things were so simple. Keep your eyes open. I hunger for the day when our power will be restored. We will meet again.
Apprentice, do you have the artifact yet?
You wouldn't want to spoil a surprise now, would you?
Oh, you're teasing me, Apprentice. Hurry back to Scotia's. I mean, my chambers. I have a surprise for you.
I love surprises.
Trust me, you'll love it. Now hurry back with the artifact. I can't wait.
Fantastic, Apprentice. You're just in time for my surprise. Since you left for the Dark Temple, I've been reading and reading and reading. Scotia's chambers are a treasure trove of research. Now, who would have thought a man like that had such a curious intellect? It almost makes me regret that we had to kill him. But I digress. I trust you were successful in the Dark Temple?
Did you expect otherwise?
Of course not. But tell me, how did you manage to pacify the apparition?
Apparently, he was my ancestor.
Remarkable. A slave's lost ancestor turns up in the Dark Temple, and I sense your incredible destiny doesn't stop there. I've been studying Tulak Horde's artifacts closely for some time, and one glance at this one you've brought back confirms everything I've suspected. These artifacts will change everything, Apprentice. You especially. They will make you more powerful than you could imagine. I have foreseen it.
I don't know. I can imagine quite a bit of power.
Never such as this. This artifact is one of five that together describe a peculiar ritual used by the great Tulak Horde when he conquered the Dromon system. Until I have all the artifacts, I cannot understand the full nature of the ritual. But I have foreseen that you alone will wield the ritual's power. The artifacts are scattered across the galaxy, some hidden by Tulak Horde himself, and some wrenched from his hands by betrayers. Documents and Scotia's effects point to Balmora and Nar Shaddaa, but I will need to do more research to locate the other two.
What do I do to get there?
Ah, yes. That brings me to my surprise. If you're going to find these artifacts, you'll need a ship, and so I have ordered you one. All you need to do is pick it up.
For me? You're too kind.
Yes, you've earned it. You'll find your ship at the spaceport. Then, the galaxy is yours to explore. Don't forget to contact me when you reach each planet for more information on the artifact's locations. Good luck and good hunting.
Ababarna Habens, Glaubbena, Ni in Usakwai, Usiterens Apipao.
I am 2VR8, factotum droid for this vessel. You must be my new master. Gentle, kind new master.
So, I get a starship, and a servant too. Not bad at all.
I am relieved, pleased that you find me agreeable. I will never disappoint you, master. I am programmed for a wide array of tasks, including but not limited to meal preparation, ship maintenance, janitorial duty, and etiquette. Welcome aboard this Fury-class Imperial Interceptor, a versatile craft combining a starfighter's maneuverability with armament to rival larger military vessels. You'll find all of the standard amenities, including your own private captain's locker for storing valuables. The astrogation console contains a constantly updated map of the known galaxy. Interstellar communications are accessed via the ship's holoterminal. Priority alerts that you may find useful are available from the Imperial Holonet console. Lastly, the ship's intercom will inform your crew that you wish to issue new orders. Any questions, Master?
I have a mission to complete. Time to see what this ship can do.
Thank goodness you aren't deactivating me. I mean, good luck. I regret I am unable to offer you combat support, Master. Frankly, my chassis couldn't withstand the stress. However, should any errands arise that are beneath your superior status, please do not hesitate to call upon me. I function to serve you. Whenever you are ready to depart, consult the galaxy map on your bridge. It will program the proper astrogation coordinates and activate the engines.
Aglausai unzaf pama ubilin. Usatida sin fara alaim jaal in ima jahaban iten.
My power is greater than any of the fools that surround me.
Jinasiwe jaalaize nam nadize. Ustaupaim I see jai in alam is frumadain habans. Gamlin ist franjan kupainanan.
Not many people lock their allies in stasis for centuries.
Iswarim ja algamboze uspalib. Ni havashun isquis kai jukai wijans in haumanai.